Some people hustle food, some people hustle cars. But have you ever heard about the man who hustles stars? Jack Horkheimer, star hustler, director of the Miami Space Transit Planetarium.
Our episode for this week, Monday, August 20th through Sunday, August 26th, is Yes, Virginia, there really is a Milky Way.
And now here to tell you all about tonight's sky and the biggest show of all, the universe, your star hustler, Jack Horkheimer.
Greetings, greetings, fellow stargazers, and I couldn't count the number of times I've mentioned our galaxy. And in this episode, I'll not only talk about our galaxy, I'll actually show you how to see a lot of it at its very best, which coincidentally happens to be during the month of August. Now, when we look up at the constellation Andromeda, we can see a fuzzy patch of light. And if we look at this fuzzy patch of light through a telescope, it looks like a giant spiral pinwheel. And we now know that this spiral pinwheel is a humongous family of suns, many of them just like our own sun, many larger, many smaller, about 100 billion suns, with all of the trillions of planets that undoubtedly go with them. And we call this family of suns a galaxy. Now, it is currently believed that the family of suns, that is, the galaxy of suns to which we belong, looks very much like the spiral galaxy in Andromeda, although there is currently some talk that the center of our galaxy might be shaped a bit differently. At any rate, we know that our sun is simply one of over 100 billion suns that make up our Milky Way galaxy. And our sun is located about two-thirds of the way out from the center in one of the spiral arms. Now, since we are inside our galaxy looking out, it would seem logical that if we looked toward the rim of our galaxy, that we should see a lot more stars than if we looked up through the top of our galaxy or down through the bottom of it. And it would also seem logical that if we look directly toward the center of our galaxy, where the stars are concentrated most densely, that we should see the most stars. And such is the case. But most of the stars in our galaxy are so incredibly far away from us that they don't show up as individual points of light. Indeed, whenever we look towards the rim or the center of our galaxy, all the light of the billions of stars fuzzes together in a blur. But we can see this blur, and people have been fascinated with it for thousands upon thousands of years. We call this blur of light, which looks like a ribbon of dim light stretched across the sky, the Milky Way. And early evening August is about the best time of the year to get the best view of the Milky Way as seen from our position inside it. All you have to do to see it is get far, far away from city lights and all artificial lighting of any kind and have a clear, moonless night. For even the bright light of the moon wipes out the dim glow of the Milky Way. So, any moonless night in early evening August, that is around 9 to 10 o'clock your local time, simply go outside. And if it's clear and you're far away from any lights, you will see it stretched from the northeast horizon directly across the zenith overhead and down to the horizon due south. And if you take a good pair of binoculars or a small telescope and aim it at the Milky Way, you will see what looks like millions of tiny specks. And believe it or not, each tiny speck is a distant sun, perhaps with its own family of worlds. Yes, indeed, there really is a Milky Way, invisible from cities because of city lights, but it's there, and it's beautiful. And in August, it's just waiting to be seen if you remember to keep looking up.
Hustler is made possible by the P.L. Dodge Foundation, the Abraham Schwartz Estate, the Rosenberg Foundation, and the patrons of the Miami Museum of Science and Space Transit Planetarium.